My name is Jiang Yong from Alibaba. Well, today I will give a presentation on the image distribution in cloud native era and what we have done in this aspect. Well, for the agenda of my introduction, in the first part, I will talk about the basic knowledge of Docker, and then we'll talk about the Docker call and introduce the image and what we have done in the image level.
Well,
before Docker launched, we just imagine a small sized company. We do not need to deploy many resources on the single devices. So all the resources can be deployed. We do not have need to address the problems like resource conflict or resource fighting. But with the business volume increased, with a limited resource, we have to deploy the same, but deploy some business on the same device. At very beginning, we thought of the VM technology to address the issue, to split the, or isolate the business, so they will not influence each other. But for VM, they have some problems. For example, the startup time is quite too long and it will take up additional memory and CPU. Well, for the core part, it actually is always developing well for the limited space and the secret technology. And XRC technology, when this technology is developed, we can put the we can isolate the business long time so that different apps so the resource grabbing of different apps will not influence with each other. So once we solve the volume process, we still have the problem of remote app conflicting. For example, for one app rely on the Python 2.7, the other app rely on Python 3.0. So for the deployment, they still have some conflicts. But for the multi-core, we actually introduce a matching technology. All what we relied on, actually, we packaged them into the same image package, and we deliver it to the maintainer staff for them to do the deployment. The image has many benefits. For example, if one application relies on Python 2.7 and the other relies on Python 3.0 version, since they rely on different images and they will not conflict with each other. So we have one benefit that during the interaction, and the developer perform much of the work. And once it runs, we can apply it into many other aspects. Once the parameters are set, we can run 1 or 10 resources. There are no differences. And actually, LXC have other technologies. At the beginning, actually, it used LXC technology, but after that, we do some optimization. Later, we found that was not that user-friendly. We need additional steps to do the image or to do the business distribution.
For now,
LXC has addressed the and Docker CN has addressed the conflict issues and the isolation issues. But for most part, it was relying on the internal Linux core technology. If the Linux core have some bugs, or it failures or have some
failures.
And then the data may be released to other containers, and it will affect the whole process or the performance. So for Alibaba, some teams are working on this. We draw lessons from the Google technologies, and we do the safety. We work more on the safety to provide the safer and more secure environment. And we have the safety of the VM and have the performance of the normal container. Well, for the Docker, I want to talk of the three core concepts of Docker. Namely, image, container, and the registry. For the image, it's quite an entity. But for the warehouse, it's where it restored the images. But for the container, it is actually in the running time for the image. We can use an image to start a container. And once we commit the container, we can generate a new image on the top of that. But we cannot start a container without the image. That is to say, if we want to start the container, we need an image. And for Docker, it actually uses the different connectors to generate a separate image. That is to say, for the first image, it is generated by the tab. And on top of that, we can perform various of jobs and generate images that we demand. This is the image building. Once it's built, we need to distribute the jobs in the running environment. We cannot transfer the jobs with the tab package. So here comes the repository. Once the image is constructed, we will distribute it in a repository. When it needed to run, and we can pull the images from the repository, and then we can generate the container.
We can give some orders. And the third step is the installation. So as you can see from this process, the first from,
it is a
fundamental image. And accordingly, it comes from a tab. And on top of it, we execute, we install.
So it will add another layer.
So this is an add, remove, or delete. But we find that the fourth step, it should not be added another layer.
And it has
what kind of layers does it need? And what about the configuration of the image? So it is in manifest.
The building of the image,
you can see this has different layers and different steps. They are read only.
So the image is read only, but when the container is running, it needs to read and write the documents of the system. And this is a container running situation. And the third layers, they are read-only layers. These are the images. And the top layer is read-write layer. This is the container. It is written by the container, and the data that is to be read or to be written is all in this layer. And they are labeled, but they are not, the documents are not deleted. So here, there is another problem. Like Alibaba, it is such a large-sized company. Actually, we do not write the business from the very beginning to the end. But we have some special techniques and to build our own businesses. For example, within our enterprise, our group, sometimes we will have a special technology. That means we need to have some data in our container. And the container needs all of the data needs to be dragged into the container. So it suffers a lot of, the image suffers a lot of pressure. For example, 1G or even 2G, 3G. And another problem is, at present, our system, it is a distributed system. So within this distributed system, sometimes we have some information center, the database, So finally, we will find that the image would be timed out for the businesses, because the businesses account take up too much space. Including the fundamental data, finally we will find that the image would be even 4G to 5G. Okay, and also like Alibaba, it has millions of the posts. And every day we have thousands of orders. And it has many jobs, a large number of jobs. So
if
all the machine accesses the image center, then there will be time out for the download on the image.
So there will be very
serious time out.
Additionally,
if it is serious time out, and you may also encounter some other problems, like the image cannot react to the data. So in future, maybe we should also have some other techniques to deal with this problem. But it will lead to another problem. That means the download will be even slower and slower. So the situation might be even serious. So faced with these problems, the first solution is to use the P2P distribution platform. And here I will briefly introduce its architecture. There is a configuration center, and that is on the bottom. So the middle part, the middle layer, it is cluster manager, and the bottom level, it is the physical host for running the cluster, and the configuration service. We manage all those physical hosts and through which nodes are the most appropriate, because we have many hosts and each host has different configurations. So the simplest way is to at least you need to select the hyperlinks. And for Docker, Because it has Docker mechanism, and on the physical host, we deploy the practice. So when Docker downloads the image, it is just like an HTTP request, HTTP request. And we can transfer it into another request. So that this request can download the data through the hypernodes. And on the right side, you can see the data source. This is an instance. We'll download a document and how to process it. For example, the node is on the layer of the image. And when it initiates a request to the hypernode, and can detect whether this layer already has the data or not. If it already has the data, then it can download to the physical host. But if it is without the data, then it can send the request to the image center.
然后，因为我们像我们发容器的话，可能是几百，几百个。So
when we distribute the container, because normally it is hundreds of containers. So for the same way, the request on the same layer, we will send them to the hypernode. And this hypernode would download the data. And to distribute the data into different parts. And maybe there will be one node already downloaded the data, but another hasn't downloaded the data. So it can distribute the data to the one that hasn't downloaded. And so it can release the pressure of the node. So we can just assume that we have 100 hosts.
Actually,
there is only one hypernode to download the data, so it suffers much less pressure.
然后的话，就是蜻蜓，我们。
And this is the effect of the dragonfly.
我们看一下绿色的线。
And let's see the green
line.
So without dragonfly, with the increasing concurrency, then the average cost is increasing. And when we see the orange line, although there is a slight increase on the time, but it will just be ignored. So the dragonfly is more smoothly than native. And that means it can substantially reduce the pressure that it suffers.
然后，其实，应该说，so
in fact,
在很早以前，在阿里还没有用
very early days, we already have Dragonfly.
应该是，I
think Dragonfly is
应该是在阿里。 Before Ali Docker,
we already have T4, this kind of technology. And this technology solve the data distribution problem. So from that time, we already have Dragonfly technique. We already have Dragonfly business. So through P2P technology to solve the download problem. And in 2015, in September, at that time, Docker comes to Ali and it has the image distribution download. You can support the image distribution. And in 2016, through our Double 11 festival, it becomes infrastructure of our document distribution, and in 2017 we have an optimization of it. For example, the memory, file system, the preheat, and the dynamic compression, and open source. In 2018, it joins the CNCF and becomes a sandbox project. And still, we are reconstructed and to optimize the Dragonfly. For example, previously, we now refactor with Golang and support HTTPS registry and more than 50 adopters to increase its capability. So actually Dragonfly has solved a lot of problems. But still we discover that there are still many problems to be solved. In our business, because a Docker Hub is just randomly to write it, and that is why we continuously to communicate on how to optimize or how to reduce the layers so that it can have an even more rapid distribution. But the businesses, they have their own KPI and their own objectives, so it is quite hard to do so. So at present, currently, the best thing that we have done is to upgrade the fundamental infrastructure. And because only system is about 2 to 3G, and we will optimize it. At least to optimize it into about more than 1G. So 1G has been reduced, and the download time will be shortened by 20 or even 30 seconds. So this is even more acceptable to upgrade. Another point to make is Alibaba emphasizes a lot on the safety and the security. So first reason is to solve the size of the image, and second is the security, to ensure the security of the image, and our businesses needs to be updated at the same time. If without any update, there will be some security problems, and we need to be responsible for this. So every 8 years, we will update it, and 90% of the businesses would use the fundamental image based on the updates. For the fundamental image, why it is so large? Like the Bitfocus and many other images, it is of hundreds mega bits. But for all the businesses, we will try to include as much as possible. So that means the fundamental image becomes even larger and larger. And at the very beginning, maybe we didn't have some normalized operations. So all these issues lead to the large scale of the image. But actually, it does not need so much.
And we must speed it may take 1 minute.
or extension, if it's not in the peak value, and it will not use if affect the user experience. For example, we launch 100 container, it can be upgraded from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m. If one container is upgrading and the rest of the remaining 99 is serving the users, then it will not cause any problems. But for capacity expansion, it's different. It's another story. If we
want
100 container required
for
the 5 million users, and now they dramatically need 500 containers, and the response time will be time out, so the user experience will be worse. So for this time, we need the quick capacity expansion. And most of the time of this process are consumed on image downloading. And for another problem is the gzip performance is too low. Actually, gzip is quite an ancient topic. The compression efficiency is quite low. For another reason, we believe previously when we encounter a situation, when we're downloading the image, gzip need to take up a single call and to do a single thread processing. If two or three images downloading simultaneously, it will take up two or three calls simultaneously. It will cause jitting of the business. Previously, we often received such feedback. So for this issue, we have done some minor optimization. As you can see on this slide, for the first case, we can have one GIP to compress that, we can have 40 million. And for the second case, when uploading the images, we do not compress them. We can compare the time consumed for both scenarios. For the first case, we found the time consumed only take a half of that with the images compressed. But the image folding time process is quite a time consuming. It almost the same to the image downloading time. So if we do not compress the images or do not optimize the process, it will take 3 more seconds. This is not very significant, but it has another significant improvement in that it will not affect other business. And besides, the dynamic process can be released. And for the physical machines and the hyperlinks, the transition speed will be is using a more better process than gzip.
就是清洁方面，我可能所做的一个优化。然后的话，
that was optimization for the struggling. The second optimization is for the remote disk. For now, we add one more image and to convert that into a remote image, which is stored on the remote disk. So the real data can be stored on the remote disk. The image record the ID of the remote disk. So in this way, when we download an image, it only needs to download the ID information. And the size is quite small. And the size may be only several K. So we can have achieve the the second level image downloading and folding.
And
with this, all the devices deployed in the same rack or the same DC, almost we don't have any latency. Well, for the remote DC, we have another question. Previously, we, during the single day sale festival, when we do the large scale expand for the remote DC, we found a question that would the physical level take up by the business? By a large demand, and we may access to a bilingual file, it has to be read from a remote DC. So, because it does not have enough memory to read this file, so all the data have to be uploaded to online. And we found that about 15 level bandwidth have been taken up by the remote, remote DC.
For
the second question, and if any problem or any failure happened of the network, so what the container cannot handle that. It definitely will meet some difficulties. Well, for the third part, well, the first issue is about the high cost. When we use one device and we use a one remote DC, may have several racks, it will cause very huge cost. Well, for now, we use a Dandi technology. We want to reduce the cost, and now the data are not stored on the hyper storage, and it can be stored on NASA servers. And during the transmission period, we found when we have the remote DC, the data is not compressed, so the transmission process will have lots of pressures. Well, for now, we use a high efficient compression algorithms, so the pressures will be reduced dramatically. And for now, we compared with the remote DC adopted previously, we now use a local host caching. So once a container runs a business, all the data of these same images can be pulled onto the local device. Well, this is the slide for the compression algorithm. Previously, we always want to replace the remote DC, but for some old containers or old versions have already run that it's not easy to migrate into the new versions or decompress into the new versions. So we cannot just delete the old servers or DCs. Well, for the sixth part, we find the 60 million of content. Well, for the green part, we found the speed just increased dramatically. And here shows the efficiency result comparison. And this is about the local caching. We found some similarity, similar findings. If we have the files storage on local devices, we can just read them directly. If not, we'll just access to the remote devices. What is the Dandi technology or other technologies? We have to convert the remote images. And it would definitely take up a lot of resources and the containers. So we have to address many issues. Okay, this is my presentation. Thank you.